Master Cormac. What you have learned from Le Chasseur was confirmed. The local lawbreakers are changing tactics.
What's their plan now?
Their boss has hired Benjamin Franklin to produce new weapons for them. He's very well guarded.
Benjamin Franklin? The scientist?
You have heard of him. Good. He is making equipment to spread gases among the populace. Toxic ones, as it turns out.
The populace? I thought they would use it against the authorities. Though that would be terrible as well.
The ruffians we have arrested refer to an intimidating woman. I believe she is behind these nefarious plans.
I look into this.
Thank you.
Hope. I pray it's not you.
Yeah. Shay, it is good to see you again. Your friend Hope said you were away.
I was. Sir, I've come to collect the results of your experiments.
Oh, well, it's a very good thing then. I just finished fixing the prototype. Here you go. I was preparing to leave for Philadelphia and then Europe. I was invited to lecture in London. Oh, would you be so kind as to inform Mistress Hope?
Of course. God, Hope. What are you doing with these felons? Turning the city against itself. What have you become?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
No. Yes, just old memories.
When I am issued new recruits burdened with regrets, I tell them the surest way to lose them is with gunpowder.
You're right, Colonel.
This prototype seems very powerful. Use it with care, Master Cormac. Our intelligence says this thing can destroy certain fortifications, as well as injure several enemies at once. There is also a more subtle way to use it. Some of these grenades contain a strong sedative. Fire one into the crowd and they will fall asleep immediately. We should test this new weapon. Use it against that door. Go ahead, Master Cormac. Shoot the door. Go ahead, Master Cormac. Shoot the door. Go ahead, Master Cormac. Shoot the door. Good work. Good work. I think you are ready to turn this new weapon against the ruffians who would have used it. There is an abandoned factory nearby hiding a dangerous poison. Right now, it only causes sleep. But I fear those outlaws are distilling it. A more powerful formula could sicken or perhaps even kill most of New York.
But that's my first target.
Be careful, Master Cormac. We understand that the ingredients are highly unstable.
All the better.
I mess with you. Maybe I can break the whole system.
This is dangerous!
must get out, or I'm as good as dead.
What marvelous destruction, Captain. I saw the smoke all the way from the Morrigan.
That should discourage those miscreants. New York is safe for now.
With all due respect, Colonel, it's going to take more than a few explosions to get rid of this kind of trouble.
The boy is right, Colonel Monroe.
Shay, was it? Congratulations. We just burned a whole lot of rats out of New York. I'm Jack Weeks. This is William Johnson. I don't know about him, but I'm pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
It is, terribly dusty here. I'm sure Shay can recount his adventures to us over a pint. Hey, the first round's on, the Colonel, huh?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
Just a little confused. I must have breathed some of that gas.
Some ale will do you good. Come, we are all friends here. You will be taken care of.
From the Colonel.
Dear Master Cormac, my apologies for the brevity of this missive, but it is time we were honest with one another. You have demonstrated your loyalty and resourcefulness to the Templar cause, and this despite and perhaps because of your assassin origins. The manuscript the assassin sought has been in my possession for some time. I reclaimed it when my men found you marooned. The Grand Master himself charged me to discover its meaning, a task I regret I have failed to complete. I leave it in your charge, Master Cormac. There is no one else I trust more. Now I leave for Fort William Henry, an ill-prepared garrison surrounded by hostile natives and the French army. We have requested reinforcements, but I doubt they will be forthcoming. I have no illusions that our resistance will be successful. I commit my life to the British Army, and my soul to the Father of Understanding. Yours, Colonel George Monroe.
captain has the wheel!
Mind your post, guest. The colonel's in trouble.
How do you mean, in trouble?
He's at Fort William Henry, facing impossible odds.
Get off your lazy asses, lads, and man your stations! We raise anchor!
Sorry for the early libation, Captain. But do you realize that it's been a whole year since we met? A whole year! Changed my life, you did. And for the better. You will forgive me if I have been celebrating without you.
A whole year. Yes. I have a question for you. How long have you known of my, well, former allegiance?
Oh, you mean the Assassins? I knew that ages ago, Shay. I may be drunk, but I'm not blind. Some homicidal search.
Anything.
Well, the Colonel wanted us to avoid influence your decision and help countless others besides. I would have made you an official Templar months ago.
Fire! 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 Monroe mentioned a Grand Master.
Oh, yes. The Grand Master of a colonial rite. You like him, Shay? His father was an assassin.
Really? He must have a story to tell.
Fort William Henry.
The garrison is surrounded, and reinforcements are late.
General Montcalm has been blazing a path across the colonies for King Louis, hasn't he?
I rather wish he'd stayed home with his mistress.
His or King Louis's?
Either, though I suspect the king's is finer.
Indeed. Madame O'Murphy is supposed to be quite the charmer.
And O'Murphy is in the French king's bed. Now I know you're pulling my leg.
She'll be a fine ship for the fleet, Captain.
Loose and cut the wind!
Loose the mains! Half sail!
Crap! Reefing on tops!
Anchor!
Thank you. Captain's at the helm!
Unfurl, mates! Let's move! Starts out!
Thank you.
Where's the helm?
Get the mainsails into the wind! Tops, gallants, royals, studs!
Drop anchor!
clear to go?
Shay, you are a sight for sore eyes.
Jack?
Colonel Monroe surrendered to General Montcalm. The French and their Abenaki allies took Fort Henry. Johnson was supposed to bring reinforcements here.
I don't see anyone else.
The Abenaki are restless. They don't understand the terms of surrender and refuse to heed Montcalm. The colonel and his men were released this morning. They're walking into an ambush.
Wait here in case Johnson arrives. I'll protect the colonel.
Thank you.
Maybe I can finally repay my debt to him.
I hope it's not too late.
From the shadows, I strike at you.
I hope I'm not too late. Too late.
Good work, men.
That's the last of them.
Master Cormac.
Sir, we must hurry.
We should bring what's left of your men to the Morrigan.
A welcome offer, Captain Cormac. Follow me. Safe passage is ahead.
So if you don't mind me asking, what happened at Fort William Henry?
Poor planning and poor luck, I am afraid. Montcalm was able to bombard us for days.
Damn frog.
Actually, he acted with great honor. When we sent for Parley, he returned an offer far more generous than anticipated. We kept our arms, and more importantly, our colors.
Only to walk into a trap.
I would hardly expect the French to defend us. Would you?
No, I wouldn't.
You continue to prove your loyalty to the Templars, Master Cormac. Risking your life for me.
We're not out of the woods yet, Colonel.
As for my loyalty, well, I do owe you.
Don't I? You saved my life. Gave me a second chance.
We have been working together for a year. During that time, you have rendered many great services. Whatever debt you imagine you have towards me is paid, would you say?
Perhaps.
You
Take cover!
Keep together, men!
I'll take out as many as I can. Your men moving. I'll scout ahead and signal if there's trouble.
A sensible strategy. Very well. I will lead my men around the stone.
Hurry. The Segawase
will not relent.
The Segawase. You know this man.
Aye, Colonel. He is one of Achilles' men. An assassin, as I was.
So they know I am a Templar. And now this assassin knows you live.
And work with Templars. I'm no fool, Colonel. The assassins will come after me next. We're both targets now. You know that's a trap, right?
Indeed, Master Cormac. But we have little choice. If we survived French cannons, we will survive this.
Pass the crow flies! I see him!
Follow me.
I've got a shot. Press him hard. Trying to give us a split maggot.
Make haste.
You really think we
can't? Loose the sails.
You heard the captain, men. Let's get out of here. Move. Move.
Shay.
I owe you my life, Master Cormac.
As do I, Colonel.
We have much to discuss. However, I must tend to my troops.
Sir, I will accompany you to Johnson's trading post at Onaquaga.
Then I shall depart at once. Master Cormac, meet me there.